Video, I'm basically going to share how I'm feeling in my new place, my new environment, my new home, my new city, and how I'm adjusting to the Southern lifestyle. I'm gonna give you guys all the tea, so just sit back, relax, and enjoy. Just some green tea. I was trying to decide what kind of tea I wanted to drink because you guys know I love my herbal teas. So I was like, you know what? What do I feel for? And my spirit led me to some green tea. I haven't had green tea in a while, actually. I like to drink teas in the morning before I eat breakfast. And green tea, what I realized is on an empty stomach, it makes me feel nauseous. Very weird thing, but I realize whenever I'm throughout the day, I eat and then I drink a cup of tea, it doesn't bother me. This is without sugar. Most of my teas that I drink, I don't add sugar to it, except for peppermint tea. And Cersei sometimes. So anyways, I made a community tab post yesterday and I asked you guys to leave some video ideas in the comments. I figured I'm going to just share them with y'all today. How am I adjusting to my new apartment and all that stuff? I feel like a breath of fresh air. I feel good. There are obviously some days are gonna be better than others, but it's all a state of mind. It's all about trying to make the best out of any situation. I can't tell you that every day is all peaches and cream. I would be lying if I said that, but you have a choice, you know? You have a choice to be happy, or you have a choice to let whatever circumstances that you're going through dwell on you. So you have choices. Like I said, some days are better than others, but for the most part, you know, everything is going smooth. Everything is going as planned. I'm taking it all in. Okay, so let's talk about the people here. People here are super, super friendly. They will literally like start a conversation with you. And it's sometimes like, and it's not them personally, it's because it's just a different, it's just different to me. You know, I'm not used to somebody just being so overly nice, even though it's really messed up because that is how we're really supposed to be. But of course, you know, different environments programs us to make us feel like it's not the norm, but it really should be the norm. Say if I'm going shopping, right? And I'm in Walmart. When I tell you, I was getting so tired, and this is a very bad thing to say, but I'm gonna say it anyways. I was getting tired in a good way, not a bad way. But I was getting tired of basically saying, it's okay, no problem, because everybody literally would say, excuse me, or pardon me, or I'm so sorry that I'm in your way. When they're trying to pass you by, they see you there, they acknowledge you. And that is just a shocker to me, how polite and how mannerable these people are. Obviously, everybody is not like that. But when I tell you the majority of the people are, and it has nothing to do with color, has nothing to do with race. Everybody does the same thing. Let's talk about jobs for a little bit. Are jobs hard or easy to find here? The jobs here are so easy, you guys. In the South, everything just is so much different. People have their own experiences, and somebody else might say it's not. But from my experience, yes, it's extremely easy. Someone on Snapchat asked me this, how did I find the job? All I do is Google. The same way I told you guys how I found my apartment was through Google. Same thing with the jobs. Google the kind of jobs that you want. If you want stay-at-home jobs, Google those. If you want customer service, Google those. If you want a banking job, Google those. Like anything, Google's your best friend, guys. Utilize it. I'm gonna tell y'all something else that's gonna really blow your mind. When I tell you, I've never ever seen this, never ever, which was like crazy. I think I did about 2 or 3 interviews literally on the spot. I don't care if I'm just gonna fill out an application. I'm gonna look the part in my black and my flats. You know, I didn't go in jeans or anything like that. I went to show up ready. Hello, I'm here, what's up? I'm ready to work, I'm ready to get this money. You know what I'm saying? So that didn't really have nothing to do with it, but I'm just saying, that's just me, how I roll. Like I said, finding them is not hard at all. These people really help you down here. You're not gonna feel helpless because they really help you. And that's something that I'm really, really grateful for. Do I miss New York City? Honestly, I don't think about New York City. Funny thing is, right, I was making fun. I was saying to myself, the other day. I was like, wow, like such a difference. I don't have the guys on the corner when you're walking by and then you have all the guys just turning their heads and staring you down. It's very annoying, and not just annoying, it's very disrespectful. I find it's your eyes, you could do whatever you want with your eyes, but I find it disrespectful for you to just stare at a young lady or a woman walking by. That's just my personal opinion. So that's one thing I realized, and I was like, I don't get that here, because ain't nobody hanging on the corner. It's a suburban area, so it's definitely different. Everybody is just going about their business, and that's what I love. You know, nobody's on the corner hanging out, idling. It's just a totally different environment that I love. I haven't developed a consistent morning routine yet. I'm just gonna, you know, just relax and ease into things. I do take my supplements every morning, kind of juice as well every morning, most mornings, but when I do start my morning routine, that's gonna be a part of it, you know, juicing every single morning. I don't wanna start something and then mess with the schedule. I wanna get my schedule going with work, and then I can figure out what time I need to wake up, what time I need to go to bed. I really feel like I'm on my grown woman-ish. I really love this move for me because I am an adult and I feel like I literally grown in 3 weeks. The good thing about it is it makes me not wanna to get comfortable. It makes me not want to settle. It's pushing me to rise up and to make the best decisions, you know, financially especially. I feel very grown in here, so it just really matches my vibe, you know what I'm saying? Other thing somebody asks, am I scared? I'm not scared at all. As y'all can see, I'm a go get what I want, period. Like, I'm not gonna wait for anybody. I'm not gonna wait until, some people might say, oh, I'm gonna wait until I get married, or I'm gonna wait until I do this. No. I have to put my best interest before anything. And a lot of people let fear get in the way of them not achieving their goals and their plans and their dreams. I'm not even scared of being in here by myself. Like, I don't hear any creepy voices. I don't get any bad vibes. My main priority was to make sure that the area was safe. Being that I'm a woman living alone, that was definitely a concern for me. So there's not people, idle people hanging around. There are a lot of people here are, you know, they go to work. I haven't even met neighbors. I think there's just one guy down the hall, and he has a dog, because I hear the dog barking sometimes. And the funny thing is, not overbearing at all. When I first came, I was like, dang, man, I'm gonna have this dog barking in my ear when I'm trying to go to sleep. Just once in a while you might hear him do a little bark, and that's it. I don't think anyone else is on this floor, honestly. I think I picked the right floor and everything, and everybody's pretty quiet, you know, so everybody stays to themselves, and that's what I love. Another thing is, goes with the scared part, is do I feel lonely? No, I'm not lonely at all. In fact, it worries me a little bit to know that I am this comfortable with being by myself. And I don't want to push this topic to make people feel like it's okay, because I am well aware that as human beings, we're here to be around other people. I'm not saying be around by yourself all the time like me. And I could just be feeling this way because I'm used to it. I find happiness in thinking about my future. I find happiness in becoming the best version of myself. I don't need anyone to make me happy. I don't need anyone to, and I think that has a lot to do with healing as well. Okay, now one more thing is, let's talk about transportation, getting around. And even with this, I don't even miss New York City for that. You would think because I am not yet driving that I miss getting on the train. It's all about what you are seeing. You have to see the future. You can't just pay attention to, you know, what's going on right now, because this is just temporary. Every stage of your life is temporary. So I don't let that draw me down. I wish that things were a little bit different. However, I look to the future because that is what matters. Looking ahead will help you so much with what you're dealing with right now. So I always try to look ahead just to give me reassurance that everything's gonna be all right. In driving, I had my driver's license since I was 17 years old, 2 days before my 18th birthday, to be exact. And I got into a situation. I had a DUI a few years back, actually a lot of years back, probably like I don't know, 9 or 10 years. I had to also pay, I don't know how much it was, maybe it was a couple of hundreds. I didn't really care too much about it. Brushed it off and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna pay another time. When I finally decided, you know what, I'm going to take defensive alcohol class you had to go through through the courts. It's mandatory through the courts that you had to go through that. So what I did was took that class because I was issued a conditional driver's license, because when you get a DUI, your driver's license is suspended. So I had a conditioned driver's license and I was ready to get back my regular driver's license. The only thing I had to do was pay whatever hundreds of dollars that was in fines and also take that class. So when I took it, paid everything, right? I'm thinking I'm about to get my driver's license back, but this was a couple years after. And come to find out, it had to be renewed. Something with the license had to be renewed. And if you go a couple of years, you have to do the whole process over. So it was nothing for me. I didn't really care too much because I was living in Brooklyn and the train systems is the norm. I had no problems getting on a train. So I was like, you know what? So that's why I didn't really take care of my license there. It is a huge, huge difference. I've just been lifting it. That is how I get around as for right now. Anyways, before I even got here, I made sure to get on it because I knew that I needed to get back my license so that I can get around and I need to get a car. But in order to even take the test, you have to even schedule. There were no slots available until almost 2 months. Anyways, I go to take that next month. When I was back in New York, I was thinking to myself, I was like, well, maybe I should stay for a few months. Maybe I should have just gotten a room somewhere. This way I'm not signing a lease and I'm not binded to a lease for a whole year. I said, you know what? No, I'm just gonna go ahead with it. Because at the end of the day, once the vision is clear, God is always going to come through for you. Always gonna put people and situations in your way to make men's meat. Didn't let that stop me. I said, you know what? No, I'm gonna just go ahead and I'm gonna start over. I'm not gonna let nothing hold me back. I'm not gonna let the driving situation hold me back. I'm not gonna let anybody hold me back. I'm not gonna allow anything to get in the way of the goal. As far as going to places, I have not done that, and honestly, I don't plan on doing that until I get back on the road and I start driving. Obviously, I do want to go to the beaches. I do want to, you know, explore, especially summertime is coming up. So I do want to be out more. I haven't really went anywhere explored yet, but it's okay. You know, it doesn't bother me. It doesn't bother me at all. I have fun in here. I cook basically every day. All right, y'all. So I'm gonna cook some dinner because it is 10 o'clock. I should have done this a little earlier, but honestly, it's about to be that time of the month for me, and you know how that goes, ladies. So I was just like, I ain't feel like getting up. I was up, but I didn't really feel like getting dressed and do my makeup to get on camera and stuff like that. That's the reason why. Anyways, guys, thank you so much once again for joining me on this journey. I really, truly appreciate you guys so much. Don't forget to add me on Snapchat if you want to see behind the scenes, because, you know, especially when that couch gets here, your girl's going to go crazy. Take care of yourselves. Until the next video, I will see you guys. Bye.